ముందుగా ప్రియమైన విద్యార్థిని విద్యార్థులకు మరియు వారి తల్లిదండ్రులకు నమస్కారం. నా పేరు కే వెంకన్న, కే వెంకన్న జూనియర్ కాలేజీలో చైర్మన్ను. నేను ఈరోజు 10th క్లాస్ విద్యార్థులను దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకుని మాట్లాడడం జరుగుతుంది. అది ఏమిటనగా, మనందరికీ తెలుసు గత 2 సంవత్సరాలుగా కరోనా కారణంగా విద్యార్థులు ఎటువంటి పరీక్షలు రాయకుండానే పై తరగతులు పంపడం జరుగుతుంది. ఫలితంగా ఐఐటి జేఈ మరియు నీట్ లాంటి జాతీయ స్థాయి పరీక్షలను సాధించడం కష్టతరం అవుతుంది. దీనిని అధిగమించడానికి మరియు 10వ తరగతి పరీక్షలో అత్యధిక మార్కులు సాధించడానికి నేను మీ ముందుకు కే వెంకన్న జూనియర్ కాలేజ్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ ద్వారా అనుభవజ్ఞులైన అధ్యాపకులచే ఉచిత వీడియో క్లాసులు, హ్యాండ్ రిటన్ నోట్స్ మరియు గత ప్రశ్న పత్రాల సమాధానాల్లో విశ్లేషణ ఇవ్వబడును. కాబట్టి నేను విద్యార్థులకు చెప్పదలుచుకున్నది ఏంటంటే, ఈ ఉచిత వీడియో క్లాసులను మరియు హ్యాండ్ రిటన్ నోట్స్లను క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో కూర్చొని చదువుకున్నంత సీరియస్గా చదువుకోవాలను. ఇంకొకటి ఏమిటనగా, ఈ యొక్క క్లాసులు విన్న వెంటనే అర్థం చేసుకుని ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయవలను. ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయడం అంటే కేవలం చదవడం కాదు, పేపర్ మీద రాయవలను. అలాగైతే గుర్తుండిపోతుంది. దీంతోపాటు మీ యొక్క నాలెడ్జ్ ని పరీక్షించుకున్న కొరకు త్వరలో ప్రీ ఫైనల్ పరీక్షలు కూడా నిర్వహించబడు. ఈ యొక్క అవకాశాన్ని సద్వినియోగం చేసుకోవాలని 10th చదివే విద్యార్థులకు విజ్ఞప్తి చేస్తున్నాను.
What a usage in Tungabhadra basin. We took an example. We cannot talk about all the rivers, right? Every river, what is a basin? River basin, a particular area where the river is there, and the area surrounding that river and the particular whole of the river including is called as a river basin. And we cannot discuss in this lesson, in this video, about all the rivers and their river basins. In this lesson, they have discussed on the Tungabhadra river basin as an example to understand the Indian river system even more better, the Indian peninsula, Indian river system, Indian rivers and water resources. In that, we are talking about Indian peninsula systems, and in depth we are talking about Tungabhadra basin. And now, water usage in Tungabhadra basin, as I said, they gave you as an example for you to understand the usage of water and how do we get, what is that you do. So it's a Tungabhadra basin was taken as an example for the usage of water. Okay, and now how do we use the water which is coming across from Tungabhadra basin? What are the ways we use it for urbanization or to meet the water demands of the urbanization? Means what? People who live in the cities. Rural means what? Ruralized. People who live in the rural areas, villages, are called as rural culture. People who live in the cities, they are called as the urban culture. So obviously, now we are talking about urbanization and the water demands in the urbanization, and what are the impacts? What are the impacts of the urbanization, and what do we have any impact because of the population growth? Is there any water change in the population because of the population growth? Any water changes? And the next thing is water in the Tungabhadra basin, and you know what is the land usage and how is unauthorized irrigation? These all are the topics which we will cover in water use in the Tungabhadra basin. Okay, this is a skeletal structure of all of the water usage in the Tungabhadra basin. So now what is it we have got to say in water usage in Tungabhadra basin? As I said, let's focus first on the urbanization and water demands. What is urbanization? Increase in population every day, increase in population density. What is density of population? The number of the people living in a square kilometer of area is called as density of the population. Day by day, the population is being increased. You know, increase in the population density, it's like residential or even commercial, industrial developments, all these things come across. Where are industries set up? Industries are generally set up obviously in this urban, in the cities only, on the outskirts of the city. So obviously, when you're talking about the urbanization, what are the three ways you require water? Their residential purpose, where we're talking about the domestic places as well as the commercial ways, and the other ways as the industrial developments. And you know, because of all these, the water is being extracted to the core, and because of this, what happens? There are irreversible damages. Means what? Once the damage is done, we cannot go back with that. We cannot even damage that. We cannot even cope up with the damage. So there are irreversible damages to the nature's flow. You keep on taking continuously, the mother nature is giving us, and you keep on digging water and doing that, and because of the density of the population, we are cutting down the trees, and because of which the rainfall is becoming less, but the water resources are also limited. Underground water, we keep on digging continuously. Where will the water come across now? So obviously, because of urbanization, we need to understand that there is the inflow of the water is also being damaged and is being interrupted, and there is an irreversible damage. Industrial growth is necessary, but because of the industrial growth, the water is also necessary in the industrial growth, and because of the requirements of the residential, commercial, industrial growths, there is so much amount of damage which is being done, and the natural water flow is being interrupted. You, the generation, should understand these intricacies, understand them better, and please do not waste a single drop of water. And the next thing is the population growth. What happens with the increase of the population? What happens? The economic activity also increases. Once the economic activity increases, there are different. If you want to be in the category of the developed country, obviously the standard of the living of the people also will have to be increased. If the standard of the living of the people has to be increased, what happens? There is so much amount of competition in different sectors of the people, and industrial sector, agricultural sector, all these sectors keep competing with each other, and water is the main component, and because of the competition, what happens? The competition increases, and obviously because of the competition, what happens? There are so many differences. There are so many differences, and unfortunately very limited water resources. So obviously we'll have to understand how to manage our water resources, how to manage our water resources, always aiming at the developed, aiming at everything high, but we'll have to understand and manage our water resources. Okay, this is the second point. And the third one being water in Tungabhadra Basin. Water, we're talking about Tungabhadra Basin. So, how is the water being utilized? Water, believe me, is the prime source of survival. Any human being or even animal, anybody can survive even without a food for a particular amount of period. But without water, no one of us cannot survive. Water is the basic necessity of the human, of any living being. I will not say human life, any living being, water is the most important thing. Now, water in Tungabhadra Basin, water is the prime need of survival and prime need of the survival. If we want to grow, if we want to improve our economic standards, and you know, if you want to grow well, obviously we'll have to focus on the industrial developments. And because of the industrial developments, the water which is being utilized from the Tungabhadra Basin, because of the that particular area in the industrial development, the groundwater, surface water are, you know, they are not able to meet the requirements of the people. And the people who are living in the Tungabhadra Basin, 80% of the people near about the Tungabhadra Basin are dependent on the agriculture for their survival as their breadwinner. So obviously this is an example. Tungabhadra Basin is a living example which is being given in our fifth lesson, India Rivers and Water Resources, for all my dear students to understand how should you utilize the water, how is water being utilized, for you to understand in better. And now the last thing is, you know, land usage. For the place near this, the water, Tungabhadra Basin, how is the water being utilized? Forest area has increased. There is an awareness now everywhere. We need to plant some trees and all. There is an awareness. The land area for the forest has increased. There is a good percentage of the increase of the forest area, but land available for non-cultivation decreased. But the population keeps going, the food requirements also keep growing. But the cultivation land is decreasing, but the requirement of the food is as well growing because the population is growing. These both has to be balanced, which is not happening. If you want proper amount of water, you should have proper plants. If you have proper plants and forest, you get rainfall. If you get rainfall abundantly, the water resources are full, because these are not perennial rivers, these are peninsular rivers, right? So obviously once the water is full, the agriculture is full. But again, the population is growing and we are cutting down the forest for the survival of, for the people to live for the shelter. So everything we need to balance in a proper way so that we maintain a balance in the ecosystem. Okay, and now after that, the last point is unauthorized irrigation. The last point is unauthorized irrigation. Only some area was selected, leaving so many patches behind. it's such a huge place near and about of Tungabhadra. Some of the places only were being selected for irrigation. What is irrigation, children? Usage of water even in the absence of rainfall is called as irrigation. Storage of water in absence of rainfall. We use water for agricultural purposes. When storing of water, that is called as irrigation. But in the near about the places of Tungabhadra, there were plenty of lands, but only some amount of lands was being selected for the irrigation, and other lands were left out without any irrigational facilities. If all other places where there were no irrigation facilities, obviously they are dependent only on the rainfall. And in a developed country, a farmer cannot depend on the rainfall or the monsoon for the agriculture. A developed country should always have a proper irrigation facilities. Now we completed this topic of water use in the Tungabhadra basin.
Hello students, my name is R.K. Pandey. I have done my B.Tech from IIT Kanpur from electrical engineering. I teach chemistry in K. Venkanna classes. I head the chemistry department. The main facility of K. Venkanna classes is all the faculty are very rich in experience, and they have taught students who have secured single and double digits. They have got very good ranks in JEE and NEET. So if you are serious for your career and if you want to pursue your career in engineering or medical, you are surely welcome here. The facilities includes not only the top tier teachers, but the other facilities like doubt clearing sessions and other academic as well as personal treatment that is provided by this institute.
Rational and equitable use of water. Rational and equitable use of water. As I said, Tungabhadra basin was taken as an example for you to understand in depth. For that as well, rational and equitable use of water, there was a place by name called as Hiware Bazaar in Maharashtra, which was being selected in it, and there is like a case study which was being done on this for you all to, because obviously children, when we plan to do something, execute a plan to do, so obviously what do? We go with an example and set that example to everybody to follow the particular steps which are being followed, and how did we reach a success rate. So obviously for rational and equitable usage of water, what do you mean by rational? Means what? Properly subsidized. Don't waste the water in the limited amount of water resources. How can we achieve the grand success? How can we get everything? How can agriculture be proper? How can the industries, the requirement of industries and the basic domestic purposes can be met? So you know, they took as a case study, and they have done the case study on the Hiware Bazaar of Maharashtra. Now let's get into the case study of Hiware Bazaar. Okay, now rational and equitable usage of water. Hiware Bazaar was selected under Adarsh Gram Yojana of Maharashtra. Adarsh Gram Yojana, it's a Hindi word. Adarsh means what? What do you mean by Adarsh? Ideal. Gram, village. Yojana, scheme. So on the particular scheme, Adarsh Gram Yojana, they wanted to show an ideal village where majority of the people are dependent on agriculture as their livelihood. So Hiware Bazaar in Maharashtra was being selected as a case study, and the rigorously they have done practically, and so this has been presented for us in the class 10 in the social textbook. Okay, and now where is this Hiware Bazaar being selected? Where is it located? Hiware Bazaar is being located in the eastern side of Sahyadri ranges of Maharashtra. Eastern side of Sahyadri mountains of Maharashtra. So they after doing this Hiware Bazaar, the case study, what happened? They could understand with a proper and equitable resources, and with a proper planning, they could achieve an all-round development. So that was, at the end of the day, what they thought is rational and equitable usage of water was being appropriately delivered in the Hiware Bazaar. So obviously, let's understand what did they do to achieve this. So this is a very important question. You might get it. Well, how can you explain as a rational and equitable usage of water? Can you state? They can ask you about Hiware Bazaar, then don't get confused. And these all the points, if you you remember, very easy to remember, children. Don't get confused, very easy points. Iware Bazaar is a place which is located in Sahyadri Mountains of Maharashtra, right? Sahyadri Ranges of Maharashtra. And you know what is the first point they have done? Continuous trenches were dug on the hill slope to arrest the soil erosion. Soil erosion means what? The upper layer, which has all the abundant minerals and all, what happens? It gets flows away. So what did they do to retain that soil, to stop that soil erosion? To the upper layer of the soil is very creamy layer, which has all the abundantly enriched with the minerals and all the requirement for the plant to grow. So obviously, what did they do? They have dug continuous trenches on the hill so that all the soil, they could stop the soil erosion. And all the cream layer, all the minerals and all which are abundantly found on the first layer of the soil, that was retained. So the first thing, what is that? They have done that. And the next point, what did they do? Obviously, once these trenches were dug to stop the soil erosion, automatically, because the soil erosion was being stopped, and so obviously automatically what happened, because of the rainfall and because of the water and all, the grass kept on growing, the greenery. What do you mean by grass? Greenery. Obviously, because the soil erosion was being stopped, obviously the greenery started growing, taking all the richness of the soil. There was an encouragement for the greenery on the Iware Bazaar hill ranges. Okay. And what did they do? The best thing is they kept a ban on the bore wells. Why did they keep the ban on the bore wells? Because the groundwater, they wanted to retain the groundwater. So they kept a ban on the bore wells. And so obviously it was a proper planning, you know, ban on the bore wells for irrigation. Irrigation was being properly implemented. They had some proper plans. And you know, and what did they do? They did not allow any outsider to come and do the sale of the lands to any outsider, because you know who abided by the rules and regulations what the Maharashtra government has kept, only those people could really be a part of the Iware Bazaar. So the first thing, what did they do? They had continuous trenches dug on these ranges, and because of which the soil erosion was being stopped and the soil retained its abundant minerals and all, enriched minerals and all. And the next thing is there was a ban on the bore wells and the groundwater was being retained very well. And the second thing is they did not sell the land for the outsiders beyond this area. And the next thing, what did they do? Water availability increase. Obviously, when the water is being retained, water availability, or because of the monsoon, water availability automatically increased. And what, when water availability increased, what is the basic thing agriculture requires? Water is the basic thing which agriculture requires. When the water is increased, the agriculture, the cultivation, and you know, the result of agriculture was also increased. And in any year, there was a second crop. So isn't it a good thing, children? Yes, it was an amazing thing. There was a second crop which started growing up, and water for irrigation only through dug wells. They dug some wells in this particular area of Iware Bazaar, and through the wells, the irrigation facilities were being supplemented, and they did not allow anybody to dug the bore wells because they wanted to retain the groundwater appropriately and proper irrigation facilities through only wells. Okay. And water usage prioritization was taken up. And as I said in the couple of minutes before we spoken about how the water should be usage. Water should be usage for agriculture, industries, domestic purpose. Everything has to be prioritized. The topmost priority was for agriculture, and next for domestic, and for the animals, and third being the industries. So the water which is available in the Iware Bazaar, they started prioritizing. They understood what is the first priority of their water usage, and the first priority of the water usage was given to the agriculture, then to the domestic purposes of the human beings as well as the animals, and third it was given to the industrialization. And in the Iware Bazaar, they have done all these things as a case study, and it was a grand success. So obviously, we understand when we go through these case studies, we understand how can we usage the water and how can we use the water by rationally and proper usage of water without not wasting the water. We can understand too. The Hiware Bazaar of Sahyadri Ranges of Maharashtra is a big example how we can use water rationally by using rational usage of water. How can you achieve all the success by prioritizing usage of water in all the different sectors of agriculture, domestic as well as industrial purposes.